What is the effort you are exerting towards acquiring knowledge of the deen? Is it watching television? What is the thing which takes up your time? Facebook? Are you on Facebook all day? Fulan had a cocktail and he had, biryani, and so 25 comments for the chicken biryani. MashaAllah. In Ramadan, the Facebook now, all of the pictures in Ramadan, before they would put babies. All year you see babies. Fulan had a baby, Fulan had a baby. Now, all the pictures in Ramadan are food. Food. And people leave a comment, I can't wait for iftar to break my fast on this. I read this, I said, La ilaha illallah, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. This is the siyam. You can't wait to break your fast with a cheesecake. This is the ibadah. This is the relationship with Allah. Dreaming about food. We don't deny Allah made it halal. And if it comes to you, enjoy it. But that is not the objective of fasting. That is not the objective of fasting. So this time which we waste on nonsense, absolute nonsense, had we utilized it to learn the deen, wallahi, half of us or even all of us would be way more knowledgeable than we are right now. I'm sure you have knowledge, but you will be even more knowledgeable if every time we spent wasting, we spent it in learning the deen. This is the first step. Next time you want to put a post on Facebook or on some Twitter or whatever, say no, time out. Go get a book, go get an ayah from the book of Allah and read the tafsir. Read the interpretation. Many people, in fact almost all Muslims, have memorized Kul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Everybody knows it. But how many people can translate it to English? The whole thing. Not that many. Most people say Kul Huwa Allahu Ahad, say Allah is one. Tayyib, mashi, we will accept that, even though that is not an accurate translation. Allahu Samad. Pause. Samad. Samad. What is the English word for Samad? What is the meaning of Samad in Arabic? How many can answer? This is Surah Al-Ikhlas. This is one surah, small surah at the end of the book of Allah, which you recite very often. It's equal to one third of the Quran in terms of the content that it has. And yet, maybe 80% of Muslims don't know what Samad means in Arabic. Forget about the English translation. Do we have a problem? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. A Muslim ummah don't know what a Samad is? Subhanallah al-Azim. A Samad, just in case you're curious now, you want to know, I'm not going to keep your mind busy with it. A Samad means the one upon whom everything depends, but he depends on none. One English equivalent would be the absolute. The absoluteness, the quality of absoluteness, meaning everything relies on Allah and Allah is self-sufficient. He doesn't need anything or anyone. Allah doesn't need the throne, He doesn't need the malaika, He doesn't need Jibreel, He doesn't need Mikael, He doesn't need the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He doesn't need you or me, He doesn't need anyone. But all of us, we need Allah. From Jibreel and the Arsh and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the other Rusul, and all of the Muslims and all of mankind, everyone needs Allah. If Allah didn't will, you can't even breathe. If you can control your own breath, then you would die, because you forget. You don't have to think about breathing. If you had to control your own breath, that means you have to think every time you inhale and exhale. Most people will die while they're sleeping, because you can't think while you're sleeping. Who controls all this? Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah is As-Samad.